Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2186 and a half. Analyze InDesign data in Excel. InDesign is the world's leading software for designing books, and we publish books here at Mr. Excel. That means that every season we are working on books, and I have a great use of how to use Excel to check your work in InDesign. Now, this is coming up because I've been asked to do a 45-minute presentation on Excel for InDesign customers at Creative Pro Week in New Orleans, June 4th through 8th, 2018. These are all people that use InDesign as much as I use Excel, so I'm going to try and demystify some of Excel. And the process of getting a book ready to go to print is one of the last things you do is indexing. Indexing, I have to tell you, is boring. It is boring, boring work. So at the end of the process, you've gone through and you've marked all the pages and you have these little index entries here, and I copy those from InDesign and paste it here to this column in Excel, then use Flash Fill. We'll talk about Flash Fill at the conference to get just the page numbers. And what I'm looking for here is I'm looking for sections of the book where essentially the indexer, that's me, fell asleep, right? It's hard to stay focused. It's hard to keep coming up with stuff. So I want to look for index quality. I'm going to do this using a pivot table in Excel. So insert, choose one cell in your data, insert, pivot table, and we're going to put the data, the report here in an existing worksheet in this location, click OK. All right, what we have is we have the columns area, the rows area, the values area. And the values area are the things we want to add up, and the rows area is the stuff down the side. Now, this is going to be really backwards. I'm going to take the numeric field, which almost always goes in the values area, and I'm going to put it here in rows, like that. So these are all the page numbers in the book that had index entries. And then I want to know how many index entries on each one of those pages. So I take this text over here, this is a heading, and drag it to the values area, which will force them to count. All right, now, 1, 2, 3, 4, wow, 7 on that page, all right. This doesn't tell me a lot. It doesn't tell me sections of the book where I fell asleep. So I'm going to take this first page number right here, choose that cell. It's really important that you choose one of these cells. On the Analyze tab, come to Group field, and say I want to group this, 10 page buckets. That makes sense. So from page 1 to 210 and 10 page buckets, click OK. Now we have groups of pages, and you'll see here under count of this is heading that it seems like, you know, I'm doing about 1.4 entries per page. Every 10 pages I'm getting 1.4, but let's see if there was any parts of the book where it looks like I fell asleep. So we come here, home, conditional formatting, data bars, and we'll choose one of these fills here like this. All right, you'll see that some of the sections like that one I had 39 entries, all right, but then there's other sections like this one right here from page 141 to 150, only 10 entries, or 181 to 190, only 4 entries. I need to go back to the book and reread those pages and see if there's sections that I missed in indexing. Like, was I just not paying attention, didn't call out enough things in the index? And then, of course, InDesign makes it really easy to regenerate the index. Now, these are the kinds of things that are in my book, Mr. Excel Live, the 54 Greatest Excel Tips of All Time. But today, I'm reaching out to those people who use InDesign or Photoshop or Illustrator. This conference is for you. And maybe you use Excel all the time, but your spouse uses one of the creative tools. Have them check out creativeproweek.com. All right, today's episode, we created a stratification using a pivot table, trying to figure out how many index entries per every 10 pages. Use the group by feature on the Analyze tab, and then finally, home, conditional formatting, data bars. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.